Hey there, are you interested in creating a rental website or app like Airbnb? Or maybe you've got a cool idea to create an Airbnb clone for car sharing, boat sharing, meal sharing, bicycle sharing, or even storage sharing? Well, stay with me, because I will share a step-by-step guide how to do that and save your money. My name is Dennis Babich, and I'm the director of a software development company. So, let's get the ball rolling. Creating a rental marketplace like Airbnb is a vital and powerful idea, because it's a proven concept that you can utilize and easily modify for your niche or market without reinventing the wheel. That's why, first of all, you need to figure out what kind of elements these platforms have. In our case, it would include iOS and Android apps, a web platform for users, a web app for hosts, and a web-based admin zone. Several features are offered by the mobile app, including authorization, rental search, calendar and map functionality, payments, chats with hosts, and so on. The web platform, similar to Airbnb, provides nearly identical features as the mobile app, but with additional functionalities tailored specifically for the web platform. The web app for hosts offer functions such as adding your house to marketplace, set up the price, availability, withdraw funds functionality, discounts, and special offers functions, and so on. The web-based admin zone provides functions such as manage your users, hosts, verification process, analytics, security settings, payment management, and user support. Now, let's discuss the most crucial aspect when planning to develop an app, creating the minimum viable product, MVP, first. This is the core element. Without it, you would waste your time and money, ultimately achieving nothing. That's why it's vital to focus on one unique feature at a time and prioritize the standard 4 to 5 functions that are critical for your app's swift progress. In the software journey, following the appropriate methodology is the key to achieving success. Keep in mind that speed is crucial in the early stages. Concentrate on one feature and take incremental steps forward. Saving your funds at this stage will allow you to improve your product in later stages, implement necessary changes, and pivot if needed. This is why the MVP is so essential. Trust me, this approach will help you bring your app to market quickly and attract a substantial user base. Alright, let's talk about pricing. So when it comes to setting the price tag for your product, there is a lot of things that you have to keep in mind, such as quality assurance, bug fixing, project management, maintenance, and risks. Estimating the cost of developing unique features, especially at this stage, it's not an easy one. But hey, don't worry, because I will share the pricing for the basic MVP functionality. Here's a life hack for you. If an investor contract demands an in-house development team, you will have to open your wallet for US or EU rates. But you can always do the outsourcing of your software development expenditures to Ukraine, which can be a real game changer when we are talking about value for money. Ukraine is an absolute hidden gem when it comes to software development. Top successful startups such as GitLab, Grammarly, and Jubal have already realized the value of hiring Ukrainian developers to create high-quality software. Ukrainian developers have excellent English skills, extensive outsourcing development experience, and are known for their innovative thinking and strong hard work ethic. Okay, so what features you have to include in your MVP? This is an excellent question. Are you feeling frustrated when it comes to creating a mobile or web app without any software development experience and identifying which functionalities are crucial and which are not? I can completely understand that. That's why I've put together a powerful 10-step guide that will lead you through the journey to the app development. However, I want to be honest with you. Missing any of these stages could lead to unnecessary expenditure of your valuable time and hard-earned resources. Therefore, I'll carefully walk you through the procedure, demonstrating how to correctly establish pricing, outplay competitors, avoid common pitfalls, use successful startup life hacks, and identify why the app cost may vary from 35k to 120k. So, let's begin. Okay, so the first stop is our business plan. And this is where Lean Canvas business plan comes into play. Think of it as a roadmap that aids you in pinpointing your essential features and exclusive benefits. Begin by understanding your user groups and their main pains. What are their struggles? What issues can your service improve for them and make their life easier? This is the core element in your business. Next, explore your competitors and the solutions they propose. Identify their advantages, disadvantages, and the flow that you can copy. Your goal is to find the room where you can outplay your competitors by creating your unique solutions for your niche. Now, let's discuss your unfair advantage. This is the powerful factor that differentiates you from your rivals. Perhaps you have an insider information, affordable development crew, or unlimited venture capital. Whatever it may be, ensure it's singular and beneficial. Once you've determined your unique edge, it's time to pinpoint your early adopters. These individuals will be the pioneers to test your service. Discover where they spend their time online and brainstorm strategies to engage them. Give them an overwhelming offer. This might be via social media, influencers, or the timeless power of word of mouth. Remember, don't just think about the present, plan for the future, and think about global growth and international expansion of your platform. Having a clear vision for your app's future in 5 or 10 years is critical for attracting investors and achieving unicorn status. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comment section below. I'm always excited to help you out, and I'll personally review each comment. Also, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to stay updated and get more business insights. Thanks. One of the most critical steps in creating your startup is achieving a product market fit. Trust me, it's a game changer. So, how can you provide innovative and disruptive solutions that addresses your target audience's pains and gains? Well, completing your value proposition table is the key to achieving that. Imagine you have an exciting idea for a car rental marketplace. Let's say you're planning to create a platform where users can share their cars with others in some local communities of trusted people. Before jumping headfirst into the development phase, it's important to understand your users' pains and gains. Maybe it's fear regarding their cars would be damaged, or how to return their car when they need it immediately. Problems with maintenance afterwards, and so on. Potential gains that they are looking for, such as additional income, cost of setting, flexibility, and control of your car. That's where your platform comes in. You can provide solutions like local communities with limited amount of people, with strong verification, insurance documents in one click, car exchange offer in case of emergency, tailored car platform maintenance, and so on. When you prioritize the most significant value for your audience and keep that at the center of everything you do, you're setting yourself up for success. Remember, small companies and startups can easily outplay industry leaders by being agile, flexible, and focusing on unique and local niches. You don't have to compete with everyone in the market. Instead, focus on a particular audience and provide them with the best possible value. And always keep in mind that it's essential to fall in love with your customers' problems, not your solutions. That's how you create a product that fits perfectly into the market. If your goal is to create an app that can outplay your competitors and satisfy your clients, then you must do the work and make a proper research. Look at the giants like Airbnb and Booking.com for inspiration. They've mastered the game, and there is much to get from their successful strategies and proven methodologies. Remember, there is no need to completely reinvent the wheel. However, don't limit your research to the big boys. Venture beyond your usual scope and dive into rental marketplace startups in smaller niches and different countries. You never know what you might find. There could be a hidden gem that could give you a competitive edge in the market. Believe me, this exploration could be the most beneficial factor in your startup success. If you need some help and support, feel free to reach out to me through any of the contact details listed in the description below. I'm here to assist you, and I'd be happy to share some of my niche knowledge that could be a significant game changer for your startup. let's outplay competitors together. When it comes to creating an MVP for your app, you have to keep your focus on what matters most to your users. And that's where a story map comes into play. With a well-crafted story map, you can break down the user requirements and map out the essential features that need to be developed and launched quickly. But wait, there is more. To ensure maximum satisfaction, it's important to develop separate story maps for each user type. Think of it like giving each user group their own treasure map, leading them to the features that are the most important to them. By doing this, you can identify what each group needs and prioritize the features accordingly. This way, your MVP will meet their needs and prioritize the best possible value at this stage. So, the greatest power of a story map is that it allows you to save money on one hand, and on the other hand, it enables you to concentrate on delivering the most value to your audience at the proper stage. Marketing might seem to be a challenge, but in reality, this labyrinth is not so scary. Basically, you require a focus on several vital elements to make it succeed. The first step is to craft unique and juicy offers that will motivate your users to engage with the platform. It could be affordable pricing, flexible reservation options, 24/7 customer support, insurance, or any other powerful marketing hook. Then test these offers on Facebook ads and pick the most effective ones. Once your killer offer are in place, it's time to broadcast them. Begin by identifying popular personalities on YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram. Then buy ad spaces in their content. But please, please, do not create a boring ad. It's not gonna fly. Be creative and find ways to distinguish your ads from the crowd. Make it fun. Here's an insider's tip. Prioritize small-scale content creators, especially in the early stages. They often have a true engaged audience, which means that it would be the best value for money for you. So, never overlook the influence of these small creators. They could be the secret ingredient to your marketing plan. Are you looking to dive deeper into the world of startups and businesses? Do you want to be a part of the business-minded founders and entrepreneurs? If so, click that link in the video description and join me on my Telegram channel right now. Okay, wireframing. By sketching out every possible user scenario and case, you can ensure you don't overlook any hidden or unexpected functions. Let's assume you're in the process of creating a car rental marketplace. You've nailed down the basics, such as user authentication, payments, and car description pages. But how about those situations where the car runs of fuel? Have you built in a feature to manage such scenarios? These are the kinds of issues where a wireframe will assist you in identifying. Listen, your wireframe is the skeleton of your app's functionality, and you have to make this foundation rock solid. Okay, let's discuss the skin of your app UI design. There are two core aspects. First, the design should be modern and sometimes even fancy. After all, we are living in a modern world, and nobody wants to use a system that has a bland, meh type style design. Second, and most crucially, you need to align your UI design with the most biggest problem of your audience and emphasize it. It's really that simple. Here's a pro tip for you. To generate design ideas, explore portfolios on websites like Behance or Dribbble. Look for marketplace apps and incorporate design elements that pique your interest. Emulate the best artists. Copy. If you have found value in these tips, hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. Your support will boost the video's visibility in the YouTube algorithm. Thank you. Now, let's dive into the tech stack. Picking an incorrect or overhyped tech stack can result in challenges like slow user interfaces, non-scalable and non-maintainable cloud infrastructure, high costs, issues with payments and subscriptions, and the danger of your app going offline during traffic spikes. Okay, if you're on the path of creating a car rental marketplace, it's vital to select the right tech stack that allows rapid development of your minimum viable product. Flutter or React Native serve an excellent choices for Swift mobile app development. For backend development, Python, Django, Node.js, and Amazon Web Services are perfect. React, Vue.js, and Angular are ideal for crafting web applications with ease. Additionally, leveraging third-party services like Stripe and Braintree for payment processing, Twilio for SMS, and SendGrid for emails can accelerate your development timeline. Keep in mind, it's crucial to pick the suitable tech stack for each stage of your software development journey, beginning with a minimum viable product, but also planning a future feature set when designing your app architecture. The right tech stack, it's like a correct diagnosis after a blood test. Alright, let's talk about the Agile process, one of the most powerful methodologies out there that can really speed up your development process significantly. However, did you know that in some situations it can actually slow down your project speed by up to 30%? For instance, let's say you have a team of 5 developers who know their roles, communicate well, and have made significant code progress on the product, which means that they can use straightforward tools like Trello, Asana, Google Docs, and Quick Meetings to great effect. However, when your team starts to grow to 15 or more people, you might run into these problems: losing your core developers, complicated onboarding processes, lower team productivity and communication issues, missing deadlines, and a drop in the code quality and architecture. To avoid these problems, it's important to bring in a tech lead to oversee the team and code architecture, hire a technical project manager, implement Scrum, sprints, backlog, and retrospective processes, use daily stand-ups, and keep everyone up to date on pending tasks. Use advanced tools like Jira to manage tasks and track velocity. Selecting the appropriate tools at the correct moment can expedite your progress towards achieving your minimum viable product. However, keep in mind, even the finest tools can result in failure without the necessary knowledge or expertise. Here is a pro tip. Agile methodology can be an asset not only in your software routine, but also in your daily tasks, business, and marketing. It's a really incredible tool. Gathering user analytics is an indispensable practice in the tech realm, enabling you to discover key metrics such as unique visitors, user behavior, and frequent sessions. Utilizing robust tools like Google Analytics, Session Stack, Firebase, and Mixpanel will help you grab all important data. Just as athletes require periodic health assessments to maintain optimal performance, your app needs a regular health checks to ensure it remains in prime condition for its users. By consistently monitoring your app's performance and analyzing user feedback, you can pinpoint areas requiring improvements and deliver superior experiences to your users. Alright, if you're thinking of creating your own rental marketplace, but you're not quite sure where to start, or if you need some advice on how to make your platform stand out from the competitors, feel free to shoot me a message via Calendly and we can have a 30-minute call. Trust me, I'll be more than happy to share some insider knowledge and expertise with you that could be a real game changer for your startup. So, what you're waiting for? Let's make it happen. See ya!